is Miss Ellen with Calvert Library. Welcome to another edition of It's Elementary. Today we're going to hear a story about words and how much fun we can have with them. When we're finished with our story, we're going to make something called an acrostic poem, and I will tell you a little bit more about that in a little bit. But first, let's hear our story. Our story today is called Sparkle and Spin, a book about words by Anne and Paul Rand. We'd like to thank the publisher, Chronicle Books, for allowing us to share this story with you today. Let's take a closer look. Sparkle and Spin, a book about words by Anne and Paul Rand. What are words? Words are how what you think inside comes out, and how to remember what you might forget about. A word is a thing you heard or saw, or can even draw a picture of. Words are the names of objects like book and doll and chair, or of animals like bird and dog and bear. Words are the names of people you like, Sally and Mary, Thomas and Harry. Words tell how you feel, fine and dandy, and I like candy. They also say what you can do, jump and run, and have a lot of fun. Words can ask for what you want, where are my shoes, or bring you news from the wide world over. Words are yes I will, and no I won't, but they are polite too, like please and thank you. Some words are as big as tin to nabulate, while a word like A, as you can see, is just as small as a baby bumblebee. Words can say how hot the sun has got, or tell how pretty a seashell is. And surely you've found words sometimes sound exactly like what they're supposed to be. There's toot toot, wee, and whoa. And when you hear about the rumbling, rolling roar of thunder, you never have to wonder what it is. Some words are gay and bright and full of light, like tinsel and silver and sparkle and spin, while lurk and murk or moan and groan are just as dark as night. A word is something you shout, bang, or boo, when you jump out from behind a chair, or something to whisper softly as the little breeze that says hush, hush, as it rustles the leaves. A word can warn that someone's sick or bring somebody running quick. Sometimes one word sounds the same as another, like hair and hair, or pear and pear. And if you spell fair, F-A-I-R, it could be where a carnival is. But fair spelled F-A-R-E is what you pay on a train when you've grown too big to ride for free. Words can say, wake up, wake up, the day is fine, the sun will shine. Words can sing a song or say, good night, mother. This is what words are for. All these and many more teach us how to talk to one another. The end.
I hope you enjoyed that story. It really reminded me of how much fun words can be. So I found a really neat kind of art activity that we can do using words. This activity is called writing an acrostic poem. You maybe haven't heard that word before, but you've probably seen an acrostic poem somewhere. Have you ever seen a poem or ever written a poem where it starts with all the letters from your name? For example, my name is Ellen, and if I put my name, E-L-L-E-N, all the way down the left column of a piece of paper, then I could take each letter from my name and start a sentence describing me. And it's kind of a cool way to play with words and maybe describe somebody you love. So today you can think about what's your favorite word. Would you like to make a poem out of that? Or would you like to use your name? Or this is actually a fun activity to give somebody for a gift. like your mom, your dad, your brother, your sister, your friends. The sky's the limit. Whatever word you want to do is great. So I chose the word winter because that's the season we're in right now. And I basically just took a piece of colored paper and I used some pencils and then markers, and I wrote kind of a little poem about winter, and I made some cute pictures here on the end. So you can see this would be a really fun thing to do at home and then to give as a gift or keep for yourself. So I'm going to take a closer look up, a camera view of this so you can see what to do. Be back in a minute. So here's a much closer view of the acrostic poem that I wrote for today's element. It's elementary. I decided to go ahead and write about the season that we're in, which is winter. So I took the word winter and I wrote it all the way down the left side of the paper in capital letters, W-I-N-T-E-R. And the idea is to then write a sentence out of each one of these letters describing the word that you chose. So each one of these sentences tells a little bit about winter. Then I drew some pictures on the right-hand side to kind of go with my sentences. Sentences don't have to rhyme. They can if you would like. I'm going to go ahead and read you my poem. W, wet and white when it snows. I, icicles sometimes form. N, not my favorite season. T, temperatures are cold. E, even snowmen bundle up. R, really early sunsets. So those are all the ways I like to think about and describe winter. And I drew pictures on the side. You can see my snowman is all bundled up. Drew my sunset down in the corner. Had a lot of fun with this. You just need paper, markers, crayons. Think about a good word that you really would like to write about, or it can be the letters from your name or a friend's name. The sky's the limit on this. So hope you enjoyed this. I hope you get real creative and have a good time. Give it a try. Thanks again for joining me, everyone. Hope you enjoyed our story today and making a really fun acrostic poem. Hope to see you at another It's Elementary in the future. Please keep an eye on all of our social media feeds for Calvert Library and all of our programs for adults and children. Thanks again. Bye-bye.